Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, here in front of Jean's house. Somebody is inside, hoping it's Katrina and not a Snatcher. So I have to go past those really difficult shooting sequences. So, yeah, Katrina, let's knock. Let's be civilized. Katrina, are you in there? Miss Gillian figures it'll be Katrina as well. Who is it? What if I just knock again? Katrina, would you please let us in? Give me your name. Who is it? Who's there? Alright. Stop messing around here. You're Katrina, right? I'm a junker. I just started down at Junker headquarters. My name's Gillian Seed. I'm pretty sure the chief would have let her know. Really? Are you really a junker? If you are, then show me some proof. Proof? Your junker ID, of course. I won't believe you unless I can see some proof that you're who you say you are. What if I just knock instead? Just messing around, guys. It's you, huh? If you're a real junker, you have to show me some proof, or I won't let you in. I can only show the junker ID. Well, it looks genuine to me. I can't trust you with just that. Tell me how old my father is. If you're a real junker, you'd know that. Oh, jeez. Wasn't he 55? I'm guessing? How old is my father? What do I press when I'm done? Enter? 55 years old. That's right. Sweet. That's still not enough to trust you. Now I'm going to ask you something about myself. Okay. What is it with all these questions? She knows that, as a junker, you should have access to Alpha 1. You saw her data on Jordan, didn't you? Yeah, but I didn't memorize it. She's a very smart girl. I have a unique mark on my body. What type of mark is it? Oh, right. The birthmark. You know, I got confused in an earlier episode. I thought the birthmark was on Mika. It's on Katrina. Put your answer in the start, press the start. Oh my god. A thigh? Inner thigh? I'm just gonna put thigh. How's this? This has gotta be it. You just made a wild guess, didn't you? If you're a real junker, try again. Oh, god damn it. Katrina is under a lot of stress right now, Metal Gear says. She does not seem to want to believe anyone. I don't want to head back to the office just to find out where the goddamn birthmark is. One more time. What type of mark do I have on my body? Oh, I thought you meant where. Okay, it's a birthmark. Just once you said where. No. Move when I tell you to move. Sometimes it doesn't respond. Guessing they have birthmark is one word. Should be. Doesn't mean it is. That's easy. A birthmark. That's right. Now tell me the shape of that birthmark. God damn it. I don't remember that. Gillian, you have to input something. I don't know. You don't have any idea, do you? I have to head back to the office. Damn it. Hope this is your last question. We'll be back. Maybe we should try again later. All the way back to Junker HQ. To use a Jordan computer. I have no idea, I have to memorize that. Welcome back, Gillian. Let's just go to the computer room. I hope we never use this card. Otherwise, we'll be stuck. Heart-shaped birthmark, inner thigh. I was gonna put inner thigh next before I realized that it wasn't where she was asking. The birthmark is what it was. Which is birthmark. All right, heart-shaped. We'll send her an invoice for the gas or whatever the hell that thing uses to travel back and forth. Investigation's going slow. Hope we can get inside this damn house now. And away we go. Do it all over again, or we're just gonna... We have to do it all over again, don't we? That's not enough. Answer the question. Alright. What type of mark do I have on my body? Just gotta do it all out again. Hopefully we just have to put in heart in that heart-shaped. Heart-shaped! Okay. That's right. And finally, where is this birthmark located? Should I put thigh or inner thigh? I'm gonna put inner thigh. I'd like to see it for myself, baby. I know that one. On your inner thigh. Well, it's pretty embarrassing, but at least I know you're the real thing. Wait a minute, I'll open the door. I was just about to think, was this embarrassing for her?
I'm very sorry about all of that. I'm Katrina Gibson, Sean's daughter.
I'm so sorry.
What's the matter, Mr. Steed?
I'm very sorry, Katrina. It's my fault your father's dead.
Gillian.
No, if I could have gotten there just a little sooner, your father might still be alive.
Oh, Mr. Seed, I appreciate your feelings, but I was always ready for the worst with my father. Every day as I watched him leave for work, will it be today, tomorrow, I knew it was a dangerous job.
Katrina, that's...
Well, I'm a junker's daughter.
Do you think you'll be all right by yourself?
I'll be fine. Don't worry about me. I can take care of myself. Besides, I don't think I have any tears left.
Katrina, are you sure?
Okay, Junker, you've got work to do, right? Keep yourself busy. That's the best way to take your mind off of it.
Okay, Katrina, you're probably right. I'll appreciate any help you can give me on this investigation.
Well, that voice actress was phoning it in. Let's look around and investigate and stuff. Abundant natural resources? Seriously. Abundant natural resources. No wonder she's working as a model. Gillian, please restrain yourself. Please, I'm used to being looked at, but it's always through a camera. I'll just pretend I have a camera up on my face. Please don't stare at me. My makeup is a mess. It is. There are antiques everywhere. It seems that Jean had quite a taste for old furniture. And old discs and keys. So maybe we can use this disc at his own house. All of these are quite impressive pieces. Our house is full of this stuff. Dad kept buying things long after we were out of places to put them. Can't investigate Katrina. He has paid a lot of attention to the decor and layout of the place. Pretty stupid since there were only the two of us here, huh? None of these items are replicas. They're all genuine antiques. None of this stuff is really valuable. He said it was all used. Still loving the music. So I guess we're asking about Gibson. I didn't really talk much with my dad lately. He was always so busy investigating stuff, cooped up in that study. Oh, Dad. I'm sorry. I'm sure you didn't want to think about it. If I had known this was going to happen, I should have been nicer to him. Gillian, you were the same way. You never know what might happen to yourself. You really should tell your wife how you feel. I've been doing that, Metal Gear. I really don't know anything about my dad's job. Me? I'm just a spoiled brat who never cared about her parents. Jeez, don't be so hard on yourself. I'd prefer it if nobody bothered me right now. We have more questions to ask you about, Napoleon. I can't believe my dad used informers. He never said anything to me about anybody named Napoleon. Buffalo restaurant? Do you know of any places that serve buffalo? We found buffalo in your dad's stomach. Buffalo? We never had that here. Gross. Buffalo? I'd never eat that. Oh no, the poor buffalo. Aren't they almost extinct? No idea. Alice is our dog. Dad named her after her mom, after she died. PC 68. A computer? There's one in my dad's study. Alright, let's show her stuff. You have to take my dad's place and protect the city, okay? Okay. I don't need any money. I've got my dad's savings. I'm fine. Besides, if I get into a pinch, I can make plenty doing some extra modeling. Scrap of paper. That's my dad's handwriting. He was always leaving memos all over the place. I have no idea what this means. I wonder if that's my dad's. I think so. It was the key to your father's desk. Oh my, nobody uses keys like that anymore. Yeah, true. Nobody. Not anymore. That's horrible. Wow. This is my dad's. Where did you find it? In his trench coat? In his locker? At work? This is definitely my dad's. Or was it in his desk? I think it was in the coat. A disc? It looks like the ones my dad always used on the PC 68. Okay. Do something. Flirt? Oh, she's 18. Wipe away tears or persuade, console. Katrina, I'm sure all of this is quite a shock for you. Don't worry, I'm here for you anytime. You can lean on me. Metal Gear says, oh, Gillian, spare us, please. Thank you. You're really a nice man, Gillian. Come on, Katrina, you've got to pull through. Okay, Gillian. If I need any advice, I'll be sure to ask you. Cheer up, Katrina. Don't worry. I'll be okay. Wipe away tears? Here, let me wipe your tears. Metal Gear says, Gillian, I saw you blow your nose into that handkerchief. Shut up! He thinks, damn. I hope she doesn't notice. Thanks, Gillian. I'll be okay. Thanks. Persuade? Are you busy tonight, Katrina? Why don't we go out? Are you kidding? What do you think? How about cheering up over dinner and breakfast at my place? Dinner and breakfast? Are you serious? You know, it's perfectly natural, when surrounded by death, to have sudden urges. Oh my god. What kind of urges are you talking about? Very naive. Let me comfort you tonight. Gillian, you're going too far. Katrina, I must have you! Oh my god.
Get out! And I thought you were such a gentleman. Don't come back either.
She kicked us out. She got upset and threw us out, Gillian. What shall we do? Come on, Katrina. Open the door, will you? You again? What do you want? Go away. Wow, really? Alright. Let's see. Thank you. Right, we gotta do this all over again. I'll see you guys. When we're back to where we were. Okay. Gonna do everything except the persuading. Well, I've already done it. Yeah. I've already looked, investigated, I showed her all the stuff, I asked her about everything. And I consoled and wiped away tears, and I'm gonna leave the persuade alone. I'm sure our wife will appreciate it. Okay, so we're gonna move into the study. Do you mind if I take a look in your study? Go ahead. This is Gibson's study. This is my dad's study. I haven't touched a thing. It's just the way he left it before he died. So got everyone telling me it's the study when I specifically walked in here knowing it was the study. Everything is neat and tidy, just like John. Wait, there's a personal computer here. They were doing that last. Desk? There's a bottle, a photograph, and a chessboard on the shelf. Oh. We have a piece to put on it. You can see the garden from here.
A garden?
Wow, his own house with a garden and everything. Yeah, but it faces north, and it's really quite small. You don't want it to face north? This is the model PC-68 Genesis. Wow, really. These have not been manufactured for nearly 50 years. My father was always using it. Some junk shop gave it to him, and he fixed it up. It's still full. It appears to be new. What's in the bottle? It's a photograph of Jean-Jacques Gibson. It's a chess set. The pieces are very neatly arranged. My dad really liked chess, but he always seemed disappointed because I couldn't play. I meant to hit that, and the same thing. Very neatly arranged. This is my dad's personal computer. He sort of used it like a diary. He said it's over 50 years old, and it's the only one like it left in the world. He always took good care of it. So he really is into antique things. See if she has anything new to say. Still a little creepy, but... Okay, we're gonna investigate now. The window? It's a wooden window with an aluminum sash. Now analyzing. It's a sunscreen. It's a standard type designed to block ultraviolet rays. There's a sticker on the bottle. This is probably from the place where it was bought. It says the store with everything, Plato's Cavern. I wonder if I should look up Plato as a name at some point. However, how did he figure on sunscreen? There must be some meaning here. Is it okay if we take this? Go right ahead. I have stored the sunscreen. It's ordinary sunscreen. There's a sticker with the logo of the store where it was purchased on it. What was my dad doing with this in the middle of the winter? I wonder if he'll see if there's anything to say about the chess piece now that we're in the area with the chessboard. What about the disc? Alright, same thing. The picture seems to be a few years old. Jean looks rather young. Katrina, do you mind if I borrow this picture for a few days? No, go right ahead. I have stored Jean's picture. It doesn't show as evidence, that's funny. Place took good care of that, Katrina says. Katrina... Oh, Dad. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to remind you. Sometimes you can be really thoughtless, Gillian. Oh, jeez. Alright, nothing new. Just bored. The Black Queen is missing. I see. The queen is missing, eh? The design of this set matches that of the piece we found in Jean's coat. That piece I've got definitely goes to this set. Probably opens a secret door. Let's... Let's use the computer. Investigate computer first. Has a 5-inch disk drive installed. 5-inch, huh? Well then that disk must be for this machine. There's deductive reasoning. Let's try to see if we can read it. Okay, use computer is not under there. Use, okay. Alright, let's turn this PC-68 on and let's see if we can read the disk. So the house in that search the house was referring to Gibson's house. And that exclamation point was not an exclamation point at all. It was a symbol for the 5-inch floppy disk. Ah, yeah, true. Look closely, the pattern matches the read-write holes on the disk. Even drew a little dot to represent the index hole. Yeah, I see that. In other words, it's meant to put the disk in the PC-68 at his house. We found that out as we were about to do it anyway. No doubt Jean was worried that something might happen to him, and he prepared the disk for just such an emergency. The machine is reading the disk. Here it is.
Snatcher investigation file. Why do snatchers appear in the winter? Why are snatchers nocturnal? I believe I have found the answer to these questions. Snatchers' vampire-like behavior is due to their desire to avoid exposure to sunlight. The reason they dislike sunlight is because of their defective artificial skin.
Oh.
Long-term exposure to ultraviolet rays causes overproduction of melanocytes in the epidermis of their artificial skin, leading to a form of skin cancer with the characteristics of melanoma.
But he's got sunscreen.
In other words, what we call simple sunburn is fatal to them. This relationship between ultraviolet rays and their artificial skin should give us a way to track them down. It should take at least 6 more months before they can develop a form of skin which overcomes this defect. These conclusions suggest several useful methods for locating and identifying snatchers.
1. Investigate skin condition. Check for any evidence of melanoma. 2. Check for odor. Cancer cells secrete a unique foul odor.
Ew, really?
3. The presence of pollen. Snatchers are believed to hide in areas plentiful in Snow 9, a snow-like bioengineered pollen crystal. As such, Snow 9 can always be detected in places they appear. Snow 9 is an allergen, causing throat pain and sneezing. 4. Possession of sunscreen. In order to protect their skin from ultraviolet rays, Snatchers use sunscreen even in the dead of winter. This is due to sunscreen's ability to block ultraviolet rays.
Wait a second.
Of these techniques, 1 in 4 should prove particularly useful. In addition, besides working to prevent this skin cancer, Snatchers maintain facilities for treating artificial skin, which has actually become cancerous. I have succeeded in identifying the hospital where this is performed. P.S. Watch out for a bounty hunter named Random Hajil.
Right, Random. So that's it, huh? He found their weak point. So, why do we find sunscreen here? Is she the Snatcher? Katrina? Or did he take that from a Snatcher and just has it... He took it from one of them. I don't know. And no doubt Jean was killed because they learned that he had found their hospital. Dog?
What's wrong with Alice? Is there something out there?
A Snatcher, maybe.
Oh,
Katrina,
brother.
You stay here.
This is the garden. She seems frightened of something. It's not the wind. Something appears to be in the thicket. The thicket over there is moving. It's not the wind. Something appears to be in the thicket. Did I say that already? I'm getting some interference from the streetlights. My sensors are not at full capacity. I'm not picking up anything from the other side of that ditch.